my goodness, what that's some good food.
Yeah.
But I ain't never been one to pass up a good meal.
Oh,
man, I just love food. Food just, you know, food's always been a big part of my life. I mean, I can remember eating there since I was a little kid. And food's always been a big part of the songs that I write and that I sing all the time. And they say a songwriter, when he writes a song, he writes about what he knows and what he loves. And I do know and love food. I think y'all remember my number one hit, my first one? It's called Lying Here. I'm just lying here with chitlins on my mind. That went to number one, and it stayed there for two or three hours, and I was still outside with that. Usually I bring up a lovely young lady from the audience and sit her on my stool and sing a song to her. I'm a little lacking tonight in that young department. But I'm going to choose me one anyway. I've been eyeballing this little blonde over here. How about you coming up here and helping me, lady? Billy Nelson, well that's true, it's Billy Nelson. A lot of people wanted me to be more like my brother. Even my brother wanted me to be more like him. And he'd always say, you need to sing a song like I do. And I'd try, and it would turn out terrible. He'd say, take this little lick song, and he'd strum his guitar, and he'd say, sing it like this. To all the girls I love, you messed me up right there. To all the girls I loved before. And I sound like a howling dog, and I said, I can't do it, Billy, Willie, whatever your name is. And he'd say, okay, try this one. On the road again, just can't wait to get on the road again. And I said, you know, I ain't never gonna be able to sing through my nose like you do. And so I just figured I'd do it on my own, under my own mama given name. And so that's what I've done. But, you know, doing all this talking, man, I'm getting hungry again. I tell you what, that was some wonderful food. Who ever done all that cooking tonight? I just want to compliment you, because, I mean, you almost rival my mom. And, I mean, my mom used to cook some food like you've never seen before. Fried chicken, butter beans, all kind of good stuff. I mean, I tell you what, I always said that if I could find me a woman that could cook half as good as my mom did, that I was going to marry her. I found five of them. That's plenty of a little problem. Well, anyway, this here next song I want to sing for you, it's kind of a tearjerker. It's a love song also. And this is one I want you fellas probably to put your arm around you, honey. Maybe just give a little smack on the cheek. Maybe lay your little head over on your shoulder. Because she's going to need some comfort through this song. And it helps me up to sing it sometimes. But I read this here song right after my fifth wife walked out the door on me. And it's called Kitchen of My Heart. And I hope y'all enjoy it.
Well, I remember how hungry I was the day you left me. And to this day, those hunger pains have not went away. Well, I don't know if I'll survive without your cooking to keep me alive. Hey girl, I miss you in a special kind of way. I just want you back in the kitchen of my heart. Yeah, I miss those beans you used to cook that made me love you. Yeah, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. My formula days been cut down to two. I just want you back in the kitchen. Oh, my heart. They say the way to a man's heart is through his belly. But since you left me, all I've had is toast and jelly. Well, I might dry up and blow away. Well, I'm losing weight, seems like every day. And girl, since you've gone, I've been dying alone on my TV tray. I just want you back in the kitchen of my heart. Yeah, I miss those beans you used to cook that made me love you. Well, I just don't know what I'm supposed to do. My 4 meals a day's been cut down to two. I just want you back in the kitchen of my heart. Yeah, I just don't know what I'm supposed to do. My 4 meals a day's been cut down to two. I just want you back in the kitchen. Back in my kitchen. Girl, get back in the kitchen of my heart.
more thing tonight before I go. This is kind of on a personal level. And, I'm the daddy of a wonderful little 5-year-old boy. And I don't have to tell you daddies in here what it means when a little one of yours comes up to you and says, "Daddy, I want to be just like you." It'll break your heart, won't it? And I was in the kitchen the other day. I was eating and watching and writing a song. And I got a little plug in my shirt sleeve. And I looked down and it was a little dark. And that's his name. And he had a piece of paper in one hand and a crayon in the other. And he looked up at me and he said, "Daddy, I wrote you a song." And he handed me the paper. And I looked at it and I couldn't believe what I was reading. And now I grant you, he's 5 years old. This is not a professional song by no means. And it's not even a complete song. But it's got good rhyme and it's got good words, I think. And as I read it, a tear came to my eye. And I realized as I was reading that my little boy had just wrote a song, just like his daddy, about eating. Now granted, it's not the same kind of stuff you and I enjoy eating. It's more of a 5-year-old thing. And when I read it, I understood that in a 5-year-old's world, it was just perfect. And he looked up at me with them little puppy dog eyes and said, "Daddy, would you please sing this in your next concert?" I took a hard swallow and I said, "I sure will, boy, I sure will." Well, this here next song is by my little boy, Garth Nelson. It's called "If Boogers Were Candy." If boogers were candy, I'd eat them all day. I'd put them on pancakes, that would be great. I'd try not to eat them as much as I could. But if boogers were candy, they'd surely be good. If boogers were candy, Mom would cut me some slack. She would not yell at me when I had a snack. And if I ran out when I got through with chores, I'd come over to your house so I could eat yours.
That's not right.
That ain't Philadelphia, y'all. Thanks for having me.